Thank you for tuning in to today's service from Elm Grove Baptist Church. As we continue to move forward through this uncertain time, we're excited about being able to provide videos of each service here at Elm Grove Baptist. Please be sure to like, subscribe, and don't forget to share our videos as they're available not only on YouTube, but Facebook, as well as our newly remodeled website. Thank you again, and please enjoy today's service.
Sometimes blind us to the truth. Our Father knows what's best for us, and His ways are not our own. So when the pathway grows dim and you just don't see Him, remember you're never alone. God is too wise to be mistaken. God is too good to be unkind. So when you don't understand, when you don't see His plan,
when you can't trust.
Good evening from Elm Grove Baptist Church. Thank you guys so much for clicking on tonight's video. I know there's still a huge learning curve. There's still a lot of things that churches across the nation, ours included, are trying to figure out in regards to you being able to view the services. But we are so grateful. The staff, I know Pastor is extremely grateful to everyone who is still supporting our church. Still been watching the videos, clicking that like, clicking that subscribe, whatever it is, checking out our website. Just thank you so much. But as I'm standing here, I'm looking at an empty auditorium. I can see empty seats. There's empty pews. There's no one in the soundboard. There's no one on the piano. I only see Steve back there waiting for me to mess up on this video, so I'll have to restart it again. But it's interesting just looking out, and I can imagine that a certain thought has crossed some of your minds. I can imagine that all across our nation this evening, that a thought has crossed a lot of people's minds, and the thought of what's going to happen to the church. What's going to happen to the church? And I think of Paul writing to the church of Galatia in chapter number 1. He says, I marvel that ye are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel. I'm not saying that maybe you've shifted your entire mindset to following something different, but maybe you're not following Christ as you should be still tonight. I mean, what happened to Matthew 16 and verse number 18, which says, and I say unto thee, thou art Peter, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Don't you understand this evening? I don't know what the outcome of this virus is. I don't claim to. You shouldn't trust anybody who says they know exactly what's going to take place. I don't know what the cause is. I don't know what the reason for it is, the purpose of this virus. But I know that Satan is almost assuredly sitting down there. He's watching the people across our nation. He's clapping. He's shouting for joy because so many people tonight are turning away from God. I just showed a member of our church earlier today, actually, a clip that I saw on Craigslist, and it was a stack of Bibles, and it said, Bibles for toilet paper. And the description of the product said, hey, obviously there's no God, so clearly anybody who's in need of more toilet paper, come and take a Bible. And it's just so frustrating that people are turning away. They're setting aside God because they assume, how could a loving God cause something like this? How could something like this come in? And Satan is just, he is just smiling on us, and he's saying, man, if I could just get more of you to fall away from God. Let me assure you of something to anyone viewing this evening. We're still the church. Let me remind you of the truth. We're still the body of Christ. Get the doubts out of your mind. We're still the children of God. It is still the church, and it is still us who are following God. I mean, we're going to go through this uncertain time, and each of us are facing different things, but all revolving around this coronavirus. But let's remember tonight that the church, it does so much more than merely just get together. The church is so much more than us just assembling with one another. We are the church. And I read about what other churches are doing, and even what our church has been able to accomplish in this this time of figuring out how to get the Word of God to its people. And it's amazing to me, it's encouraging to me to see how active churches are being right now. But let's look at some things tonight, and as we just remember, we are still the church. Let's pray, and we'll get into this evening. Lord, we're so thankful for the opportunity to still spread your word. Lord, we're thankful for the opportunity to still get together with one another, whether it's over video or talking on the phone or video chatting. There's still ways for us to be the church tonight, Lord. I pray that you just hide me behind your cross, whatever I say. I pray that it will be a blessing to those listening, those viewing, Lord, just anyone who is in need of this. Lord, I know it was encouraging to me, just this topic. But be with us now, Lord, as we open up your word. In Jesus' name, amen. As a church, there are many things that as we gather, we will talk about on almost a weekly basis. There are things that we will discuss with one another, maybe prayer requests, maybe different things that we've witnessed to people, or we've done different things. But even now, from your homes, there are still things that we as the church can do. There are still things that we as the church should be doing. Praying. We should be praying. Philippians 4:6 says, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." Listen, Christ, he tells us, "Ye have not because ye ask not." If you're struggling, if there are concerns, have you taken them to God? Have you brought them before his throne and say, "Lord, I don't understand this. I'm confused." We can still pray for our situations. We can still pray for other people. We can still pray for our church, the members, the ones that we love, that we miss shaking hands with, that we miss giving a hug on Sunday mornings. We can still pray, and we should be. Are you praying? As a church, we should still be a witness. We should still be a witness. Acts 1:8 says this. It says, "But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the utmost part of the earth." Listen, ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me. It is still our responsibility as a church body, as a member of the body of Christ, as a member of this church, to witness. We can still get out there in a way, maybe over a chat with somebody. Listen, how many of us have multiple times a month, maybe someone from high school get on Facebook and say, "Hey, remember me? Hey, we used to have this class together," or, "Hey, we used to actually be friends." And you have all of these acquaintances that come across, or new people on different social media platforms that just want to follow you, or they just want to be a part of what you're involved with. And you can say and use those platforms to say, "Do you know who Christ is?" Acts 22:15 says, "For thou shalt be his witness unto all men of what thou hast seen and heard." As a member of the church, a called out body of believers, what that is saying is, listen, at one point you accepted Christ as your Savior. Okay? You have become a part of this body of Christ by choice, and you have experienced that. You have seen things. You have heard. And what I have done in my life by accepting Christ, I can then share with other people. Acts 4:20 says, "For we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard." Listen, if you're saved, we should be sharing that. We can still be a witness, even from our homes. We need to be carrying each other's burdens. We can still carry one another's burdens. Galatians 6:2 says, "Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ." Listen, as a church member, as somebody who is going through this coronavirus pandemic, just like all of you are, under the possibility of home quarantine and different things like that, I can still help somebody. Maybe reach out through a phone call. Maybe reach out through a text message. Listen, we have the capability of video chatting with people, and for somebody just to see a smile. I think of my mom. We've been live streaming our teen Sundays school classes and Wednesday night classes on Instagram, and my mom actually watched the Sunday school, and she said it was almost emotional for her because she was able to see, okay, he's doing okay. They're still doing fine. They're still able to continue. Who is it that the Lord placed on your mind? I received a video from a member of our church and his kids just last week, and it was saying, "Hey, just thank you for what you're doing there, putting on videos and so forth." And it's such an encouraging thing to be able to just carry each other's burden, just show some love to somebody. We can still fellowship. We can still fellowship. Acts 2:42 says, "And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, and in breaking of bread and in prayers." This is talking about the children of God, the church, the body, and they continued steadfastly. Listen, I might not be able to meet with you one-on-one in person. I might not be able to get together with you and your family and have a nice meal and to do these things, but I can still, like I mentioned previously, I could still make a phone call. Hey, I can still, during those live streams I was mentioning on Instagram, we've been playing games with the teen department. Hey, I can still fellowship. I can still help you in some way. I can still just be a friend. We need to be fellowshipping. Something that is so important for the church, for the body of Christ, that you can be doing and you should be doing from your home is follow Christ. We have to continue to follow Christ. Luke 14:26 says, "And whatsoever doth not bear his cross, and whosoever doth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciples." Listen, the cross was a picture of suffering, of pain, comfort, just things that were negative. It's a picture of this suffering that Christ went through. And he's saying, as a Christian, you need to be bearing your cross. You need to still understand you're going to go through pain and tribulation. You're still going to face trials. We still need to be following Christ. If you're not doing this, if you're not willing to just get up and say, listen, I still have a designated time of Bible reading, a designated time of prayer. There's still a designated time of just obeying God's commandments, witnessing, carrying each other's burdens, praying, fellowshipping. Listen, we still have to follow Christ. As the body, we should still worship. We should still worship God during this time. John 4, verses 23 and 24 says, "But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth." The first part of verse 23 says, "But the hour cometh, and is now, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth." That's so interesting to look back in John chapter 4 and say, man, this is an hour now where we truly need to be worshiping God. He desires our worship. He desires for us to just come before him with our praise, with our joy, and just understand, listen, even through though we are facing a time of uncertainty, a time of trials, we can still worship our living God. He knows what's taking place. He understands. As a church member, we can still give. We can still give. 2 Corinthians 9 7 says, "Every man according as he purposed in his heart, so let him give. Not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. It's so interesting that people just automatically get in this mindset, and I've been guilty of it myself, but you're not in church one week, or maybe you go on vacation and you're not home, you're not at your home church, and maybe you just don't drop off that tithe check, or you just don't think about it, and it's put to the back of your head, and it's like, you know what, I don't need to really give this week, I wasn't there, or I don't really need to give to God because I wasn't involved with a certain ministry or whatever it is. We still need to be given even from our home. Churches all across our nation have been able to come together and set up through different apps and different websites things and a way for people to still give and cheerfully give to God. He desires that of his church. We should still be serving. We should still be serving. Galatians 5:13 says, "For brethren, ye have been called unto liberty, only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another." Let's read that last part. "But by love serve one another." There are a lot of needs right now. There are a lot of people who are struggling with doubt and insecurity and frustration. And we can be serving each other. We can be serving each other in a way. We can still serve God. We can still serve the church, the physical called out body of believers. There are still things that we should be doing out of love. We should be serving. Let me assure you tonight, God was not sitting in heaven at the beginning of the year looking down on his children and all of a sudden say, "Oh no, where did this coronavirus come from? I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what's where it's going to go from here." God was aware. He is still in control. He is still on the throne. He is still God, and we are still his church. Tonight, as I was preparing this, it's so interesting because that mindset can easily creep in to your thought process throughout the day. What's going to happen to the church? Where are we going to go from here? Listen, we're still the church. Whether you're on your couch, at your dining room table, in your favorite chair, we're still the church. Just because you're not in a pew, just because you're not in a seat, in an auditorium, sitting in front of a pastor, you're still the church. We have opportunities now that we have never had before. I mean, sitting at home, like I mentioned, possibly quarantined, possibly out of work for the time being, possibly bored out of your mind. There are opportunities that you have. I mean, what a chance to use your time to text or to call somebody, to send an email, to send a letter. I mean, you have such an opportunity to reach out to those that maybe you wouldn't on a normal basis. Family members you haven't spoken to just for lack of time, you can reach out to with the gospel. Opportunities to come. Man, it's so exciting to think about. Reach those former high school acquaintances, like I mentioned. Those people who asked to be your friend, tell them of a loving God and say, listen, we're living in uncertain times, but there's one thing I'm certain of. God loves you and he desires for you to be a child of his, that one day he can spend eternity with you in heaven. We have such an opportunity now. Listen, church, don't forget who we are, who you are, what we're supposed to be doing. Most of all, don't forget who we serve. He's still God. God is still in control and we are still his body. Listen, we are still his church. Tonight, maybe somebody popped in your mind that you need to message. Maybe somebody popped in your mind that you need to share with the gospel. There are many people who, even myself included, there are people who I think about who, you know what, maybe they haven't heard the gospel. That's the purpose of the church. That's your purpose. Your Christ-given purpose is to reach out to those lost. Just as Christ came to seek and to save, he saved for you to seek those for him. We are still the church. We should still be praying, witnessing, carrying each other's burdens, fellowshipping, following Christ, worshiping, giving, and we should still be serving. I pray that all of you are doing well. We miss you. It's very interesting standing before an empty auditorium. But those of you sitting at your seat, just continue to love and serve God as the church does and should. Lord, we're so thankful again for the opportunity we had just to open up your word. Thank you so much for the ability to have messages and sermons posted on different video platforms. That way the church can still be involved with one another. The church can still hear what pastors are laying on their hearts through this time, Lord. Just continue to watch over our church. Continue to give us burdens to see souls saved. Lord, just thank you again for every opportunity that you'll give us during this time. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you once again for tuning into this video. The world is changing, some days quicker than any one person can keep up with. There will no doubt be changes ahead. Please monitor the new church website, the Elm Grove Baptist Church Facebook page, and the new EGBC YouTube channel for further updates. We are being bombarded with words like difficult, challenging, uncertainty, unprecedented, unchartered. As Christians, we must rely on our faith and trust in God and His Word, the Bible. Here are a few things which we know for certain. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. For I am the Lord thy God, I change not. These things have I spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, and of love, and of a sound mind. Over the coming hours, days, weeks, the current situation will no doubt change, but God will remain the same. Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you. Thank you for your continued support of this ministry. It is incredibly important at this time. We love you, and we are praying for God's comfort and protection in the days ahead.